What would you say to your younger self now, being older, when you were starting it all?
Get ready.
Hi, I'm Tate McRae, and I'm 8 years old. I love to sing and dance.
One day, you'll see me on Broadway.
I had school, then dance, and I wrote this today.
Mwah! We have a busy, busy day today.
We're shooting a music video.
I am going to be posting every single Friday.
I was a very motivated kid. Once I had a goal in front of me, it was like I would literally do anything to get to that point. I didn't have much of a childhood, mostly because I was always at dance. My mom being my dance teacher, I basically just went to my basement and said, train me, I want to be the best dancer. I would work my ass off every single day, and I was just a very inspired kid.
We like do this like dance private, and Michelle's like trying to get me into character, and I'm 8 years old, and she like does this thing. She's like, okay, you're gonna improv as like a someone's coming towards you, and she like stands up. I'm like 8 years old, I'm like, ah!
Started screaming like she was in a horror movie. And then I thought I traumatized her forever.
I isolated myself so much as a dancer. When I got to school, I felt like such an outcast that I had so much content to write about. So I had like a YouTube channel and I would constantly write about my every single day issues.
I will be calling it Create with Tate. I will be posting choreography videos and dancing videos and singing videos.
I don't even think I realized that I was able to write songs because I would purely just do it as a journal entry. It was more or less just like me needing to get stuff off of my chest. And then eventually I realized, oh, I can actually songwrite. I feel like I had this inside talent that was kind of just waiting to come out if I like actually dug into my feelings of high school. You know, that's what pushed me into the music industry.
Whenever you go out, she'll wear a tight mini black dress with all her friends around.
It's so funny because my favorite thing is when we're like in dance rehearsals for shows and then I have to like actually, we get the band together and the dancers together, and Michelle's like, oh shit, I forgot you sing. And I'm like, I'm like, true.
Or she'll like sing live, she has to do like a live vocal take, and I'm like, oh my god, that's so good. You're like a really good singer. I haven't even been thinking about that at all.
You want the girl with the small waist and the perfect smile.
In the dance world, I feel like we were always on the edge of things. Like, mm-hmm. We always wanted to do things like learn it the day before and then compete it the next day, mm-hmm. or like use paint or use like crazy objects in solos. And mm-hmm. I think it translates now because it's like all we want to do right now is just like make crazy art.
Now things are on such a big level and it's all changed and gotten so big so fast, but sometimes it feels like we're doing the same thing that we did when you were a kid, but it's just on like a way bigger level. And we actually have money to like hire amazing people.
I do this thing where I'll write down every single one of my like bucket list goals. One of the biggest ones was performing at my first ever award show, or being nominated for an award show, being on late night shows, getting like a number one. So I think there's a lot of things that have happened over the last year that haven't even like really registered yet. And then this year I'm releasing my first ever album.
I feel like I'm constantly thinking about the next thing and the vision for the future. Mm-hmm. And sometimes I'll look back and I'll be like, holy shit, in the last 7 months, my entire life is like turned around.
Writing is definitely very therapeutic for me. It's something that I need to do. That's what makes it so special for me, is that it's all really personal. If my music continues to be like a diary to me, it's gonna feel like that from everyone else listening.